Hey guys, doing a quick little video here on bow ties, and I bought a new one just now actually. It's a black one here for kind of a black tie event I'm going to this coming weekend, and it got me thinking that I should take a handful of my bow ties out. Actually, these are all the bow ties I own, and kind of go through them and just give you an idea for what to look for when you're buying one in terms of fabric. So each one of these, you may notice, is the same style. It's the slim. It's the standard kind of bat wing, sometimes it's called. So as opposed to like a diamond point, which will kind of come out like this in a shape, these are all very a straight edge. And it's very classic, very kind of works in all different situations, sort of bow tie. But let me go through a couple of them here because these are really interesting. This, I believe, came from, 1940. So this company here, I don't believe they're making bow ties anymore. This was out of the Boulder, Colorado area, making some really cool vintage bow ties. And this one in particular is just a really awesome bow tie. In terms of construction, they're all really amazing. And you can find a lot of really high quality handcrafted bow ties all over the United States. It's very popular to make them right now. However, it kind of comes down to the fabric that can really make or break a bow tie, in my opinion, because at the end of the day, and not to steal the thunder of some of the craftsmen, but there aren't a whole lot of complicated seams necessarily. But what you really notice when you're wearing one and tying one in particular is the quality of the fabric. A while back, I was tying a handful of bow ties for a full wedding party, and they are rented from one of the great big rental agencies, and the fabric was just so rough and rigid that it made for a very difficult bow tie, actually. It was really tough to tie it, but it was also tough to get a really good-looking bow out of it. And that's where the quality of fabric really comes into play. So this one was made from a really, honestly, very luxurious kind of vintage fabric. It's really thick, it's got some weight to it, but it's very, very soft, right? I mean, it's gonna conform into a lot of different fun shapes. So that's something to look for when you're looking for a fabric. Otherwise, a lot of them kind of come out to, I would say this navy one and plaid one here, and in addition the red or the white polka dot on the red here, same kind of thing, where it's a very pliable fabric, so it passes that test. It's gonna be you can tie it really easily. It's gonna have some great wear characteristics to it. And pretty basic, I think. So when I'm looking for something, I feel it, and I want to make sure that it feels comfortable. And if it feels good on your hand, then it's probably going to feel good on your skin. But more importantly, it's going to feel good when you're tying it, and that can make or break a good bow tie knot, because all of us can relate that tying a bow tie can be kind of challenging. So when I was out today, I was applying those same rules. I was looking for something that just felt good, that I could kind of fold up, but this one was a little bit more rigid on purpose because this is for a black tie event. And in particular, I picked up this one because it has a little bit of kind of a textured look to it, if you can see that. It's not a typical just matte black, kind of like this would be if it were black, which is fine. And that's partly what makes this a little bit more casual, besides the fact that it's red and polka dot. But this guy kind of stood out as something that I think would be a go-to bow tie for me going forward and cover a lot of bases and do so well. So, quick overview, hope that helped. The takeaway is that the fabric is really the most important thing when you're shopping for a bow tie, and don't be afraid to kind of, really feel it and honestly make a comparison of how's this bow tie going to feel, because that's usually a good comparison of how it's going to tie in a knot. Hope that helped. Don't forget to subscribe. We got more videos coming. We'll get back into a rhythm here. Bear with us. We've been having some issues kind of getting back into the swing of things and pumping out content. But we will figure it out, and we'll get a lot more good stuff coming your way. In particular, some good wedding stuff, which is great, obviously, if you're getting married. But even if you're not, you'll get a lot out of it. Trust me. Thanks, guys.